everyone, and welcome back to the channel. Today I have a video on how to convince your parents to get you ferrets. My live stream that I did yesterday with Brian, pretty much every other question on there was, how do I convince my parents to get me ferrets? They just will not budge, they won't listen. And so I wanted to make a video dedicated to this topic. I'm gonna give you some real advice here, and I hope that if you're asking this question that you listen closely and take it seriously. Now we're talking about living, breathing animals here, not a new iPhone or a tablet or a computer, a living, breathing animal that relies on you for absolutely everything, an animal that possibly may be your responsibility for the next 9 or so years. First, I want to say that I understand how frustrating it can be to not get what you feel you deserve. Every birthday for probably 10 or so years, I asked for a horse of my own. I had worked hard day and night, volunteered for so many years, mucking stalls, doing lessons, but it never happened. And I didn't understand until I got much older that they would have gotten me all the horses that I could have ever asked for or ever wanted. They saw how hard I was working and how good I was at caring for them, but they simply couldn't afford it. Horses are expensive. And I didn't really understand that as a kid because you don't really have a concept of money until you get much older and you have to spend it. No matter how many binders of information and PowerPoint presentations you create, if your parents are telling you that they cannot financially afford ferrets, you have to respect that. There's not much you can do. Now, you may have parents that are willing to financially take on ferrets for you and assist in that way. If so, make it a goal of yours to get a part-time job when you are of age so you can help them out. Jobs at young ages are good for building a savings account for your ferrets. Eventually, when you move out, you're gonna have to have money saved up for not only yourself, but for your ferrets as well, because they are very expensive. So it's a good idea to build that account regardless. Now, if you will be paying for the ferrets in full, but you're still living under your parents' roof and they just are not agreeing, here's a list of reasons why they may be hesitant and things that you can do to try and show them that you mean business. Ha! Get it? So the first thing might be little to no experience. If your parents think that you don't have what it takes to care for ferrets, physically show them that you can do it. This can include volunteering at local shelters or offering pet sitting services in your neighborhood. You may not meet any ferrets, but it shows your parents that you are responsible, willing, and eager to care and learn about animals. Number two, the big one, but ferrets smell. Now, I've heard this a lot. Try explaining to your parents that you will do your best to keep up with the smell and that any pet comes with an odor. You can greatly diminish ferret smell by feeding a proper diet, allowing adequate free roam time in a large enough space, as well as keeping up with their potty areas. So as long as you do all those things, the smell should be reduced quite a bit, but there still will be an odor. Number three. But they bite or they poop everywhere. Explain to your parents that you will be following the proper bite training protocols with your ferrets, as well as litter training procedures. On a proper diet, your ferret will be pooping less, so there will be less cleanup if you provide a proper diet for them. Number four, we have other animals in the house. Now, this is a tricky one depending on the quantity and species, types of animals that you have in the house. If you have a free roaming bunny or birds that fly around, definitely do not get a ferret. That would not be a suitable pet in those circumstances. Rats, hamsters, other rodents, lizards must be kept separate from ferrets. Cats and dogs can interact with ferrets supervised. If you have multiple rooms in the house, dedicate one room to be like the ferret room, and for maybe 1 to 2 hours in the day, supervised, let them roam bigger areas in your home where your cats and dogs may be residing. If you have an aggressive dog or cat, do not bring a ferret into the home. You really do not want to risk that. There are some dogs that just do not do well with change, and some cats as well, and have a history of attacking or just being aggressive or being really stressed and uncomfortable with new animals around. Please respect the other animals that you have in the home before bringing in new ones. Number five, what about when we go on vacation? So ferrets can be boarded at exotic vet offices as well as some normal boarding facilities that take dogs and cats. However, I do not recommend either of those Based on personal experience and working at these types of facilities, they will most likely not receive any or very little out-of-cage playtime. I would opt for finding someone locally to come to your home and take care of them periodically throughout the day. This is the lowest stress option for not only yourself, but for your ferrets as well, because they don't have to go anywhere. Number six, another example, I just don't want that sort of commitment. Now, this is understandable because with some kids, they will get animals and then it ends up being the parents' responsibility. I've seen this so many times in ferrets that are getting rehomed. It's because it was the kid's pet, the kid didn't want to take care of it anymore, it became the parents' responsibility, and with kids and other animals and jobs, they just couldn't keep up with that added commitment that they weren't expecting. Assure them that you will be doing all of the work, from feeding to scooping poop. If you cannot adopt, there are still many ways that you can help ferrets in your area. The first being fostering. Fostering is when you take on a single ferret or multiple for a temporary amount of time. This is to get them out of the shelter environment and into a home setting. The shelter will work to find homes for them while they are in your care. This is a great option for families who don't want the full commitment of ferrets, but they still get to enjoy the companionship and being able to actually hands-on take care of ferrets. In this way, you get to meet loads of different personalities, many different ferrets. You get to help them while they're looking for a new home, which is great in my opinion. I would love to do this again sometime in the future. If you can't foster, you can always volunteer. Volunteering at your local shelter is a great experience. You learn about so many different species and breeds of animals and how to care for them and etc. It is so much fun. I highly recommend that you look into volunteering. And if you can't volunteer, you can sponsor. Sponsoring is when you choose a ferret or more to sponsor monthly. We have three ferrets that we sponsor monthly. You generally get to choose the amount of money that you want to send towards their care monthly. This is a great option for people who want to really actually help out but can't or don't want to take on more pets. And if you cannot sponsor, you can donate. Reach out to your local shelters and see what they really need, whether it be cleaning supplies, blankets, toys. By donating, you are directly helping the shelter and the animals there. Now, just an end note here, we are at the end of the video. I want to reiterate, and if you are a regular viewer, you know how important this topic is to me. Please check your local shelters, sanctuaries, Facebook groups, rehome sites, Craigslist, and even reputable breeders. Do not go to a pet store to buy ferrets. Pet store ferrets come from a massive laboratory where they are produced to be test subjects. Only a portion are sent to the pet stores when the rest are given a life of just complete misery, never being able to see the outside, forced to breed all year round, and then their babies are taken from them right after birth, pretty much. Buying the pet store ferret just makes way for another one to take its spot. It's the same awful cycle with puppy mill puppies that you might see in pet stores all around the country, something that is being made illegal in many states. Not only that, pet store ferrets often have diseases including, but not limited to, ear mites, intestinal parasites, upper respiratory infections, and behavioral problems due to little handling and no out-of-cage time. When you adopt from a shelter, your money directly helps fund the shelter and its animals there. A spot then opens up for more ferrets in need of a place to stay before finding their forever home. Your ferret will have been seen by the shelter vet and will be adopted out with a clean bill of health. The exception of issues that can't really be cured, such as insulinoma or adrenal disease, both of which your shelter will make you aware of before you adopt out the ferret if they are aware of these diseases. When you buy from a reputable breeder, and I'll say now there are not many in the States, I will be linking below a list of breeders in the States that you can take a look at. Your money helps fund the people working to better ferrets and to spread healthier bloodlines around the country, so this is an option as well. Thank you guys so much for tuning in today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you learned a bit. Hope it was helpful. Do not forget to subscribe, like, comment, and follow my Instagram for more updates as well. I have made a new Instagram account. I will put the @ here for my raw feeding educational content. If you want to follow that, you can learn a thing or two about raw diets, and also talks a little bit more about my mentoring program, my testimonials that I have from that, and so on. And my mentoring program is still open for those of you who are interested. I'm not sure when I'm going to close it, but I have maybe 10 to 15 students right now in it, which is super exciting. I've already had about 5 or so people graduate, and it's only been out since December, so I'm super happy that it's been successful. successful, and I hope you check it out. But I'll see you in my next video. Hope you have a great day. Bye.